ज्ञानांजनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपा कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदाम्बिकं। वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरोः श्रीयुतापदकमलं श्रीगुरुं वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगणरघुनाथं रघुनाथं नितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं हरिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादां सहगणा ललिता श्री ललिता विशाखाम्बिकां च। नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णदृष्टाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नामिने। नमस्ते सारस्वतीदेवे गौरवाणीप्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादे पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद। हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
Hare Krishna, all glories to you.
Hare Krishna, all glories to Prabhupada. So today is the 10th June of 2021. We'll be reading the Srimad Bhagavatam, first canto, first chapter, verse number 8. Please read the verse and recitation.
Vetatvam saumyatat sarvam तत्वतस्तत् अनुग्रहात् भूयुः श्रीदग्य शिष्य गुरवो गुह्यम् अप्य युता। वेतात्वं सौम्यं तत्सर्वं तत्वतस्तत् अनुग्रहात् भूयुः स्निग्धस्य शिष्यस्य गुरवो गुह्यम् अप्युक्त।
वेत्तत्वं सौम्यतः सर्वं तत्त्वतस्तदनुग्रहात् भ्रूयुस्निग्धस्य शिष्यस्य गुरवो गुह्यम् अपि उत। वेत्तं त्वं सौम्यतः सर्वं तत्त्वतस्तदनुग्रहात् भ्रूयुस्निग्धस्य शिष्यस्य गुरवो गुह्यमपि उत। वेत्तत्वं सौम्यतः सर्वं तत्त्वतस्तदनुग्रहात् भ्रूयुस्निग्धस्य शिष्यस्य गुरवो गुह्यमपि उत।
अप्युतानि अप्युत I is not the your, you is that aputa.
Vitta.
But you are mean? Well conversant.
Tvam.
Your honor.
Saumya.
One who is pure and simple.
Tat.
Those.
Sarvam.
All.
Tatvatah.
In fact,
tat,
there,
anugrahat,
by the favor of,
bruyu,
will tell,
snigdasya,
of the one who is submissive,
sisyasya,
of the disciple,
guravaha,
the spiritual master,
bhuyam,
secret,
api uta,
endowed with.
Please read the translation.
And because you are submissive, your spiritual master have endowed you with all the favor bestowed upon a gentle disciple. Therefore, you can tell us all that you have scientifically learned from them. क्या बात है? Seeing the quality of Sutta Goswami, his spiritual master has endowed him with all the knowledge. Because of his gentle nature, he has learned physical and metaphysical understanding of this material world and the spiritual world from his spiritual.
What is the meaning of submissive?
Submissive means you are understanding with the I read in one of the things, one who is the best shishya is one who understands the mood of the spiritual master without his master telling him. He is the best shishya. One who understands the mood of spiritual master. That is a very submissive person.
So how Sudha Goswami is submissive?
Tadvidhi pranipatena pariprashnena sevaya. He serves Vapu and Vani with fully faith, considering that has the Sutta, his spiritual master as the representative of the Lord. Our problem is we don't consider spiritual master Srila Prabhupada as representative. Sometimes we try to avoid or not fully follow the instruction. That is why the proper result is not, we are not getting the appropriate result of prema.
So in this particular translation, why Prabhupada written the spiritual masters instead of spiritual master? Because Sutta Goswami's spiritual master is Sukadeva Goswami.
Sutta Goswami here. This thing is very much discussed in discussed in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Srila Prabhupada had given one lecture in Gauriya Math in Mumbai. Right? You have read that thing? That has been translated by Bhakti Charu Maharaj in the book. Oh, konsa book hai? Knowledge and Renunciation. There is one book, right? Something like that, right? There is one small book that has been translated by
Hare Krishna. Continue, Prabhuji.
One of the lectures by
Continue.
You can close that. In one of the lectures in Mumbai on the appearance day of on the disappearance day of Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, I think in Mumbai, Gauriya Math, Srila Prabhupada ji gave lecture and he told that my spirit is not like it is my spiritual master or your spiritual master. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur is the spiritual master of the entire universe and his instructions are universal and everybody must abide by his teaching, and spiritual master is not confined to anybody. So one of the devotee once told me that actually spiritual master is representing Nityananda Balaram. Spiritual master is representing Balaram and Nityananda. So actually when you refer to spiritual master, you are referring to the potency of Lord Balaram, Adi's Guru. You are referring to the potency of Nityananda. So that potency of Nityananda is universal in nature. It is not that you find something, this person is doing that and that some other person is doing that. It is not like that. Spiritual master is spiritual master and spiritual master is universal in nature. And that, this is told by Chaitanya Srila Prabhupada ji also. And this is told by many Chaitanya Charitamrita is written, and this is that spiritual master is universal in nature. So it is not that my spiritual master or your spiritual master or Guru is Guru and Guru is for everyone. So if there is a person who has been authorized by Nityananda Prabhu. Amar Agya Guru Hoya. Who has been authorized by Nityananda Prabhu, who has been authorized by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then he is authorized for everyone. Srila Prabhupada is authorized for Srila Sampradaya also. Srila Prabhupada is authorized for all the Sampradayas. Not that Srila Prabhupada is only confined to Gaudiya Sampradaya. Like that. So everybody must abide by the teaching of Srila Prabhupada. Everybody must abide by the teaching of Srila Ramanujacharya, Madhvacharya, Nimbarka Swami, Vishnu Swami. We all also have to abide by their teaching. Not that only we should not be abide by their teaching. They are also our spiritual master.
What is the gentle behavior of Sudha Goswami?
Four gentle behavior that Narad Muni tells to Vyasadev.
So what are the Vyasadev, gentle disciple qualities? Can you describe?
There is four na. That has been told by Srila Narad Muni to Vyasadev that he was not very when the Vedantist was staying in their. They were serving his mother and he was serving the Vedantesh for the four Chaturmas. That time, even though he was a very child, he was not very much childish. He was not interested in sports or material activity. And he was not very talkative, you know. And he was abiding by the teachings of, he was abiding by the serving nature of to them, you know. He was, So that, because of that nature, seeing the Vedantist got very pleased with the small boy, the Dasi Putra. So if one is very submissive and not very flickering in nature and not much talking, we have to use our mind and body in such a way that is pleasing. Every action must be pleasing for the, it must be in the mood of the mission of our Guru. If we sleep and if we get up, take bath, we engage our any time, that must be also in aligned with the mission of the spiritual master. Not that suddenly you start doing something and suddenly you start doing that. That is not in the mood of spiritual master. Then you are not simply wasting your energy of your mind body.
Yeah, that's great. Now we'll be reading the purport of His Divine Grace Abhay Chirnarvind Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. Purport. The secret of success in spiritual life is in satisfying the spiritual master and thereby getting these sincere blessings. Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur has sung in his famous Eight Stanzas on the spiritual master as follows. I offer my respectful obeisances under the lotus feet of my spiritual master. Only by his satisfaction can one please the personality of Godhead. Only by his satisfaction can one please the personality of Godhead. And when he is dissatisfied, there is only havoc in the path of spiritual realization. It is essential, therefore, that the disciple is very much obedient and submissive to the bona fide spiritual master. Srila Sudha Goswami fulfilled all these qualifications as a disciple. And therefore, he was endowed with all favors by his learned and self-realized spiritual masters, such as Srila Vasudev and others. The sages of Naimisharanya were confident that Srila Sudha Goswami was bona fide. Therefore, they were anxious to hear from him. So in this particular purport, we understand many, many things, especially how the Sudha Goswami is qualified to be representative of Vasudev. His control his senses, is a Goswami, and he is free from all the vices. And he learned all the Vedic literatures, he is complete, know the conclusions of Puranas and histories. In the previous verses we have heard, and now his qualities have submissiveness and his inquisitiveness, and he has bestowed by his spiritual masters, and it was gentle behavior. So because of all these qualities and character, he was empowered and he was requested to speak on the Srimad Bhagavatam to all the sages assembled in the Naimisharanya, the place where Lord Vishnu never closed his eyes. Nimisha Kshetra. So especially in this purport, we understand the importance of satisfaction, spiritual master, and getting the blessings. The everyday morning, the singing, the Mangalarati, the eight stanzas written by Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur. And one of the prayers
is the last one.
वंदे गुरु श्री चरणारविंद सो द मीनिंग ऑफ दैट इज आई रेस्पेक्ट ओबेसेंसेस टू स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर्स एंड माय ही सैटिस्फैक्शन द सैटिस्फैक्शन स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर इज डायरेक्टली द प्लीजिंग टू स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर यस्य प्रसाद भगवत प्रसाद विदाउट प्लीजिंग हिम द लाइफ बिकम्स हवाक यस्य अप्रसाद न गति न गति देयर इज नो दिस सो दिस वेरी एसेंशियल फॉर ऑल द डिसिपल्स इन द परंपरा in the bona fide parampara they had to fulfill this condition and similarly we see here the Suta Goswami has fulfilled the condition because he was pleased and he obedient to submit to his spiritual masters they are bona fide because they are coming in the parampara of Vyasadeva and slowly the Sukadeva Goswami and in that line he was understood in that way and all these qualifications as a disciples and then the qualified disciple only can become the qualified guru That is a qualification. So now all the saints, sages in the Naimisharanya, they understood that this personality, Suta Goswami, has all the qualities and fulfilled all the qualifications as a disciple, and he can fit to be speak on the Srimad Bhagavatam. And he also endowed with a very, very elevated spiritual realizations by his spiritual master. So these spiritual realizations only bestowed, endowed by the favors of spiritual masters. Especially from Vyasadeva and Sukadeva Goswami, Prasada Goswami. So they are very confident. So it is the thing that the followers, the disciples will have the full confidence on the spiritual masters, how they give this knowledge. Then when we have confidence in the personality, then we can apply the principles which is teaching and which is instructing. Thus one can easily advance in the spiritual activities. Therefore, Because all these qualities and these details of Suta Goswami, all the Naimisharanya's rishis are very confident and very anxious to hear from him, not by anybody else. So there's great lessons we can learn from this purport of Srila Prabhupada. Yes, brother, you add something?
You open the fifth chapter of Bhagavad Gita, seventh verse.
Fifth chapter, seventh verse. Okay, why this is connected to this? One minute, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna.
You write in the Veda ways, you search na 5-7. Take out on Upa Gupta and over the Chiti. Hare Krishna. So there is a poetry written by Rabindranath Tagore, which was part of our syllabus in 10th grade. So that Upa Gupta is a disciple of Buddha and is a Buddhist. He is a Buddhist monk, okay, and he is a mendicant and he is lying down on the street. And there is a dancer, there is a royal dancer, and she was walking and she saw Upa Gupta and she told, "Arey, Swami, you are a very beautiful person. Why don't you join me in my house? Why are you sleeping down the street? You know, why are you sleeping down the street? Why don't you join in my house? In my house, we can enjoy and we can sleep together." Then the Upa Gupta told, "No, I am a saint and I don't want. But when the right time will come, then I will meet you again." And then that was a spring. That was a spring season. Okay, when the leaves were very much blossoming in the trees and flowers blossoming. But when the winter season came, everything was dry. And that lady was after having enjoyment in the royal place. She was removed. Because she started acquiring some skin disease and her beauty started diminishing. And because of the diminishing of her beauty, everybody in the royal court rejected her and she was thrown down to the street. And then same Upa Gupta saw her who was lying down the street and he took her and to his ashram and cured her and made her a Buddhist saint. So she preached later. She was a famous preacher of Buddhist ideology. So because Upa Gupta was equal in both the condition, even in spring time, in the time of enjoyment, and in the time of austerity, he was in sama equal. So he was dear even to the royal persons and to the dancer. Even he was sarva bhutatma bhutatma. He is dear to everyone and everyone is dear to him. Because if you want to please everyone, you should not try to satisfy their senses by giving gift every in the rose day, you know, hug day, kiss day, this day, that day. We are Mother's Day, Father's Day, we're going to make a cake and celebrate anniversary. No, no, this is not how you please everybody. If you want to please everybody, you have to take an invert route and you have to satisfy yourself. One who is satisfied is always pleasing to everyone. Who can please everyone? Who is satisfied within own self, who has control their own senses. When Prabhupada ji went to Gopal Agrawal's house, then Prabhupada ji was making prasadam and offering prasadam and keeping in the same fridge where meat and other items were kept, in the same refrigerator. So Prabhupada ji was satisfied in all conditions, whether in the 50 degree temperature in Radha Damodar Mandir, whether his wife left him, whether his Jhansi plan got finished and got obstructed, and whether he was there in America, whether everybody was trying to steal his typewriter, or whether he was being glorified in the European Assembly. Prabhupada was glorified. Whether Bombay Temple was, or whether he was staying in Vrindavan, anywhere of the Vrindavan Temple opening, the governor of UP came, you know, and Prabhupada was very much glorified at that time. So every position, every moment, Srila Prabhupada ji was in equanimity. In all positions, sarva bhutatma bhutatma kurvanapi. Even you are performing your activity, but you are not entangled. You are satisfied within yourself. And that person who is satisfied within his own self, then he can qualify to make disciples all over the Pacho Vegam, Manasa, Krodha Vegam, Jiva Vegam, Udharapasta Vegam, Etan Vegani Vishahita Dhiraha. What is the last line? Sarvam api shishya. He is qualified to make disciples all over the world, right? One who is controlled is vague. Control. So if we can control within ourselves.
Sarvenapi maam prithvim sa shishyat.
Right? So one who is control his own senses, control his own self, one who is in as taking the inward route, then only he can please everyone. So Sutta Goswami was pleased within. Sutta Goswami is not only the reciter of this Srimad Bhagavatam. He is the reciter of entire 18 Puranas. He is only the one who recites the 18 Puranas. And the first verse of every Purana is Narayanam Namaskrityam Naram Cheva Narotamam Devim Saraswatim Vyasam Tato Jaya Mudire. This is before reciting any Purana, the Sutta Goswami is saying this Mangalacharan. Sutta Goswami is very learned person, especially in the topic of history. Okay, but he is very humble and very dear. One who is very humble and very dear to everyone, then only he can please the Lord. One person was there in a South Indian temple, and he was a pujari, and he was taking bath, and he went to the temple, and somebody touched for the seva. Okay, somebody touched him. So he got angry and he again went to and took bath and came, and again somebody touched him. So again he got angry and again he took bath. Later, by the will of the Lord, he saw that every person, every audience of every darshanarthi was waiting to take darshan of the Lord. He saw every person was Vishnu Parshad and everyone was converted into Vishnu Dutas. Then he later on did not take bath again. You are not satisfied within your own self, then you find fault into others. Why do you criticize others? Because you want that kind of glorification that he is getting. You want that kind of appeasement. You want that kind of, that is why you criticize others. He is doing that fault because you also want to do that fault. Why you see fault in others? Because you also want to do that kind of sense gratification. You are not satisfied within your own self. One who is internally serving, there is a mana mandir, mama mana mandir raho nishidin Krishna Murali. Within your core of your heart, there is a temple, Nikunja, garden of Vrindavan. And that Vrindavan, Divvidrindaranya Kalpadrumadha, Srimad Ratnagara Simhas, that Radha Govinda is residing within your heart, and you are always serving him. You don't care for what anybody is insulting, glorifying him. You are immersed, and that love that is emanating in your heart, you are sharing with others. You don't feel for Tulya Ninda, Sutir Mauni, but always calm, composed in all position, all condition of your life. that person is a real spiritual master who can spread that love to others. थोड़ा ज़्यादा हो गया.
That's great. Nice explanations. Thank you so much. Shri Shri Radha Rashtra Bihari Prabhu.
Hare Krishna. Pranam. All glories to you.
All glories. All glories. So we'll end here. Our purpose of this today's.
Yes, Prabhuji. Hare Krishna.